We've all seen this explosive confrontation between Dame Dash and Lee Daniels. What started it? Is Dame Dash just a bitter loose cannon, jealous that he doesn't have the same success as Lee Daniels? Or is it that Lee Daniels truly can't be trusted?
We were on the campaign, and she was making unreasonable demands. And, and she wasn't thinking, this is when reverse racism, I think, happens. You know, I said, you have to thank the producers of the film, you have to thank the studio. And I think she didn't understand that, and I think that, and I said, listen, people aren't going to respond well if you don't. So I love her, and I've spoken to her, and she's brilliant. I like working with brilliant people. But sometimes artists get in their own way. I think that there were demands that were made from her on the Precious campaign that everyone knows about that hurt her. And I told her that.
Can she change that?
I mean, if she plays ball, you got to play ball. This is not just show. It's show business. And you've got to play ball.
What exactly does Lee Daniels mean when he says, you've got to play ball?
They said, what is it going to take to get Monique to France, to the Cannes Film Festival? And my husband said, is there a number associated with it? And they said, oh, we would never pay for anyone to do any promotions for a movie. And we said, we understood, because what people didn't know was I was paid $50,000 to do the movie Precious. And it really wasn't about the money, and I'm not complaining, because I signed up to do it with my friend.
Yeah. But so you're saying that because you didn't have the money to do this on your own. Is that what you're saying? That you needed to feed your family and pay your bills?
I think that's what America says.
Yeah.
I think we all say, I can't do it for free.
Right.
So when the movie studio says we can't set a precedent and pay you to do this, we didn't have an issue with them.
Okay.
But that's when the reports came that now Monique is being demanding and she's being difficult. They had a request. We simply had a request. And they said they couldn't do it. And we said we understood. That was it.
Typically, the cost of promoting a film is included in the actor's salary. They understand that they need to go out and promote the film. But in this case, Monique was only paid $50,000, a really low price, in order to do a favor for a friend. But was this really why Lee Daniels felt that Monique was difficult?
Did this all start from you not thanking Mr. Daniels in your Oscar speech?
That's what we believe, yes. Yes, we believe it got started. Actually, if we go back even further.
So it's about, okay, go ahead.
Yes, we'll go back to the morning of the Oscars. Sydney and I got a phone call from Mr. Daniels. And he wanted our opinion on how he was dealing with a situation with this sister named Lisa Cortez. He had promised her something.
Okay.
And she was his producing partner on the movie Precious. He had promised this sister something. But he called us up and said, the powers that be, they want what I promised her. And now she's a little upset because I had to take it from her and give it to them. Mm. And she's got to understand, you got to know how to play the game.
Here's that play the game thing.
Well, Sydney and I said to him, Lee, if you promise that sister something, you have to give it to her, even if it means you have to take a short.
Mm-hmm.
You can't promise something and then take it back. Well, Lee felt like we were attacking him because we weren't agreeing with him. And we said, if we're truly friends, brother, we got to be honest with you, and what you're doing to that sister, it's not right. Now, I don't know whatever became of that situation.
Right.
And I do feel obligated to speak about it because oftentimes people don't get the platform to say I was wronged.
Mm-hmm.
And the reason why I'm speaking out for that sister right now this morning on y'all show is because I watched that sister put it in on that production. I watched that woman sweep poop out the street so Mr. Daniels could get the perfect shot, and she had no broom and dustpan.
Okay.
So when you call us the morning of the Oscars and you say, I've got to take back what I promised her, but you be a little upset that she doesn't understand why you have to do it, and you want us to side with you because you're breaking your word, we told him that wasn't right. So he felt like he was being attacked.
So according to Monique, Lee Daniels was comfortable with not keeping his word to Lisa Cortez, someone who went above and beyond for him in the production of the movie Precious. And remember that the confrontation that Lee Daniels had with Dame Dash was over his failure to pay back $2 million that Dame Dash had loaned him. Proceeds from the movie Precious were supposed to be used to help repay that loan to Dame Dash.
No. I put up $2 million. He had asked me to do The Woodsman and to put the money up. And I really liked the script. And, you know, me being perceived as this urban dude and Harvey Weinstein pissing me off, I was like, I want some of that money, too. I'm going to go walk the Palais at Cannes and do some big woolly shit like that. Mm-hmm. So, you know, Lee Daniels came to me with a good script. Kevin Bacon was attached to it. And I had some paper at the time. So I was like, he was like, and he hit me with all of that. Like, you know, black people don't stick together, and you know, that kind of thing. So I put up the money. You know, it was $2 million. So I put it up, and we got our money back. But then he wanted to invest in his movie, his first directing thing. And it was like Shadow Boxer, and it had Helen Mirren in it and Cuba Gooding. But, you know, it cost like $10 million, and the script was crazy. And I was like, Lee, I believed in the other script. This is my money to put into movies. It's for my independence. And he was like, I promise you, you'll get your dough back. And, you know, my... long story short, I didn't get my money back. And then, you know, we made a deal where any other project that he was on, until I get my money back, I would be on it. And then as soon as Precious hit, he just went missing on me. So then after that, we spoke. You know, he's my man. So I was like, why are you even acting like that, man? Yeah. You know what I'm saying? And he was going to put me on the Empire series. That was how he was going to squash it. He was like, I'm shooting Butler and when it comes out after that. And then, like, one day his manager called me and was like, Damon Dash, you going to jail? And I was like, why you asking me?
From Sheffield?
I was like, why? Yeah. I was like, why you asking me that? Just answer the fucking question. Blah, 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 blah. Hung up on me. I was like, God damn. So I just hit Lee like, yo, I'm not talking to her no more. I don't know why. And before other conversations, she was kind of getting involved. And I was like, you're kind of talking all my money right now, but you're a woman. I'm not going to yell at you. You know what I'm saying? I'm just not going to do it. So...
you feel like they were trying to ask you out at that point?
I don't know what it was, but the thing is, you got to understand, just because somebody has their name on it, it doesn't mean if they're not putting up the money, they don't control it.
Yeah.
And sometimes, like, black people get mad at other black people, like, you ain't doing this, and they think this, that, and the third. Like, he ain't putting up the money, he's being told what to do. So more than likely, he couldn't deliver what he said he was going to deliver.
Yeah.
So they tried to make it like I was something, like, you know, whatever it was. But I was just like, look, man, I don't want to put another black man in front of a judge, but this is kind of too easy. You know, but you can't just walk around owing me $2 million and you got it.
So according to Dame Dash, due to the way that Lee Daniels said, if you promise somebody something, you have to give it to them, even if you have to take the loss personally.
Sydney and I said to him, Lee, if you promise that sister something, you have to give it to her, even if it means you have to take a short. You can't promise something and then take it back.
So when we look back, before we ever knew who Lee Daniels was, before Precious, before any of this, he was making deals with